Today is the day. October 3rd. No, it's not the day for the TikTok Mean Girl sound. It is the day for Clean Gray, which I literally am so freaking excited for. I am not excited for the feeling after the concert of when it's gonna be over and I'm gonna have this soul crushing feeling like I'm gonna die. But right now, I can't wait to go. I'm so excited. It is currently 2:15. Concert starts at 7:30. I'm not even gonna lie. I know I sound like a fake person, but Maisie Peters is the one opening for CONAN.
Awesome.
Never heard of her. I know like a lot of people were like roasting her on TikTok and stuff. I don't think she's a bad singer. I don't care to see her. I also want to get there in time for the merch dance. Like I want to get merch before. Hopefully it won't be sold out and all that crap. So. Me and my sister driving about 2 hours to go see him in Raleigh. Okay. I'm leaving in about 2 hours. Do my hair, makeup, outfit, everything. Like I think I'll have plenty of time. But I'm just so excited. So first step, my sister's actually at practice right now. So she's gonna come home and get ready in like 20 minutes, which I wish could be me. I'm just not that person. I need 2 hours, 3 hours to get ready. And then an hour beforehand to like get ready to get ready mentally. So I'm gonna go shower, shave, hair, everything. It's not a quick process for me. I wish I was that person who could get back from a sweaty practice, be ready in 30 minutes. It's not gonna be me though. It's not like 4 o'clock. I did get kicked out of the bathroom because I was taking too long and my sister got home from practice and she's already almost done getting ready and she's been home for like 15 minutes. My hair is actually working with me today. So I'm happy with that, but I am gonna do some makeup. I do like a full hair day and light makeup or full makeup and no hair. But also like, I don't really do my makeup that much anymore. So I don't really care. I'm basically done. When I put on makeup, I feel like a different person. I love it. All I gotta do is put on my outfit. Is the outfit I spent forever crocheting on. It's finally done. I've got the shrug with the stars, this little skirt, my dog ones. I literally cannot even explain how girly I feel right now, but it's a good, good feeling. And now we need to go see my sisters because she's somewhat matching me. Okay, Grace.
Hey, these are our outfits.
We are about to get in the car. It's almost 5 o'clock. Definitely not what I was wanting to do. But I heard that CONAN doesn't actually come on till 8. I don't really, want to see Maisie Peters anyways. We're gonna get on the road. We're very excited. But okay, we are going.
Driving for 45 minutes. We only have 1 hour left.
So we're kind of here right now. Grace got too hot.
It's 83 degrees out and I was wearing like a full sweater. I'm literally sweating.
It's now in the merch that I bought. Okay, because
I'm kind of working it.
Parking was cheap and it was a pretty easy process.
Oh, and Lisa, the parking attendant complimented our outfits.
Yes, so. Yes, we love Lisa. It's like 7:30, I think, so we're getting close.
Thank you.
later, concert just ended.
It is packed.
I don't know how I'm gonna get out of here because people are rude and they're mean. Debrief after we get food because we're definitely gonna get food. It's 10:35. Yes. See how long it takes us.
I haven't eaten anything but a pancake.
Yeah, I've only eaten a cookie.
Healthy, look at us.
Pretzels.
Skinny girls.
Let me show you if I'm even gonna be able to get out of here.
Yeah, that would be mildly embarrassing.
It is now 11:16.
I wanna go to bed.
We sat in the parking garage for about 25 minutes. Not a single soul was moving. And then these Tesla people, they're like 50 years old.
And of course, they're avoiding eye contact. Were they looking directly at them?
Well, yeah, they wouldn't let me in. Because like normally when you're leaving a parking garage, it's like a zipper. Like there's a straight line and then they let the people on the sides go in. And they were just like not looking at me. They would not let me in. They're being so rude. And I was like, y'all have to let all of these people parked out eventually. So eventually, I kind of just cut my way in, which I hate doing, but I like had to do. It's like, maybe why are these
50 years the way we did the little.
Why are these 50 year olds sitting in a parking lot? Like, what are they doing right here? They didn't do something at the Conan Gray concert. I said they both had yellow and black one.
I think they had a daughter in the back.
I didn't see a daughter. So about 25 minutes later, 3 minutes later, we're out. We are now at cookout. I hit a median on the way over here.
It was bad. You would have thought she was drunk.
My baby's still going. Cookout for Gray's, and then I need McDonald's because we need separate things. We'll make the two separate stops to get what we want.
Because we are picky.
Yes. We're in cookout's line. Gray's gonna get a milkshake. We're gonna devour that food. We're so hungry. So we gotta eat it up. And then we're gonna head home. Cookout vibes. Okay, 1:30 a.m. Let's go. We just pulled in the driveway. Literally just pulled in the driveway. Briefing the concert because it first, Maisie Peters, small opinion on her, completely changed my mind because somehow we got there in time for her, which I read up online somewhere.
Yeah, that's probably gonna be really late.
How we got merch and everything, it was like 7:30 when we sat down and I thought, okay, Maisie Peters has already performed. He'll come on at 8 o'clock. That's what I had read somewhere.
No.
At 7:40, Maisie Peters came out. Actually, I was really, really impressed by her. I really thought
like
she was
I heard
good.
A lot of bad things about her, but like I don't know, she really impressed me. Like I didn't know any of her songs.
I actually like want to look her up on Spotify after this. So liked her voice. I thought she was good. Obviously, Conan Gray was freaking amazing.
As always.
Yes, I think we literally lost our minds a little bit during the concert. Eye of the Night, the exit, Marie's Cut That Always Bleed. I don't know. There's like, obviously
Jigsaw. Everyone was screaming for Jigsaw.
Yeah, Jigsaw. I don't explain, the energy was amazing.
Like the crowd, the energy was through the roof.
Yeah.
Like I don't think any concert I've ever been to has had like such a, you know, like energetic audience.
Throughout the whole concert, my phone literally every like 4 or 5 songs, it was like no storage.
4 or 5 songs.
Every 4 or 5 songs, like my phone would literally be like no storage, no storage, no storage. And it was it was awful. It was so annoying.
Huh? Some guy a few rows ahead of us had the fattest face ever.
He was like
walking all of our videos. I got a lot of compliments on their outfit.
Yes, I will say very many people told me I liked the outfit.
And I had to change into some merch.
Oh yeah.
Because I was sweating. It was like 90
like literally 30 seconds after we sat down. She turns to me, cover like listening. Take this off. And so she changed into the merch after. And afterwards, we keep everything.
Not in a hoarder way.
Yeah.
Well,
we scrapbook everything. So anything memorable,
any cards we get, any fun things we go to, it's all in that box.
Yeah. Like, once the confetti came on, we knew what we had to do. Once the confetti went out, we're in the middle section. Confetti, like every little blast piece of it, none of it went in the actual concert area. Blew all the way out by the exit. As he's like, bye everyone. He dashed the confetti and everybody was over there. It was a solid 10 minutes of like 15,000 people just shuffled like this close together.
I think it was the most embarrassing slash humiliating moment of my life, like crawling out.
Yeah, because the confetti blew all the way in one area. Everybody was over there, like everybody was on their hands and knees scraping up confetti. Grace was the confetti scraper of our group. I was
like, get on the ground, get on the ground.
I'm like crawling trying to get
it. It was very, very competitive, but I'm glad we weren't the only people
like,
who cared.
You don't want to be one of those people that like takes out the confetti, so you're trying to like get enough for us, but it was like the little fountain logos. It's really cute.
Like younger girls and boys, they were giving out these like guitar picks. Obviously us being very like stuck on, we keep a lot of things. Like obviously this will be kept and will be,
and they will be in the journal.
Also, somebody asked to switch seats with us. Oh, that was
no.
We have seats 1 and 2. So we're on the very, very end of a row, which whenever we go to a concert, I try and get us on the end because I just think it's better. We're sitting down and she like comes up and stands in front of us for a second. And I was like, does she know me? And then she's like,
just wondering if y'all want to like switch seats to us. We're 11 and 12.
In the middle of this aisle.
Yeah, but she was super nice. And I was like, actually, we're good. I'm sorry. And she's like, yeah, no problem. So she was super, super seat. But like, what? Like, that's never happened. Like, why would we switch seats with you? I don't even understand. Like, they weren't like better
seats.
She must
have switched with someone because then they were in front of us. Did you?
I thought that was them.
Heaven.
I thought that was them. 4 or 5 seats in front of us. They were not taken up the whole time until right when he came on. So I feel like they just sat there, which is like not a big deal because thankfully they were shorter than us. So they sat there and then they were taller than us.
They were both like really short. If they were taller than us, I would have been throwing hands.
Yeah,
like,
I don't know. Maybe they were so short and they couldn't see in the middle. Like either way, why would they, number one, why would they pick us? 10 out of 10 experience. The venue was very small, so it was very like easy process overall. Like going from Taylor Swift to this, like just easy process to get your seats and everything. But we are literally gonna go get the best sleep of our lives.
Literally, I'm about to pass out. Yeah. It's gonna be so good.
And that was our Conan Gray experience.
Okay, let's never do that.
Literally like on my knees immediately for him. He was so fine. Really, he was so fine. He got me giggling and kicking my feet while I was watching him. Oh, he was so fine. Anyways,
his hair is so curly.
You're gonna go ahead and stop talking now because we need to go to bed. It's like 1:30, going to bed. Great experience.
10 out of 10.
We love Conan Gray.